Check. What is up, guys? A few months ago, I was in the market for a new camera, and this is an exciting time as a photographer and as a filmmaker. It was kind of a bummer because the 70D that I had started my career with and had put through years of abuse finally died. This camera was way past its shutter count. It's a little beat up, but I really liked this camera. I was either gonna go with the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K or the 6D Mark II. And those are two wildly different cameras, and you may be asking yourself, why was it between those two? And it's kind of the push-pull I had with what I wanted to be doing creatively and what I was actually doing professionally. I wanted to be able to shoot log and then grade the hell out of it in post. But on the other hand, I still occasionally get work for stills photography. I kind of needed something with autofocus, so I ended up with the 6D Mark II, as you can probably tell by the title. Here is five reasons why I absolutely love this camera. The first reason is the price. I think I paid $1,300 for the 6D Mark II, and that's almost the same as I paid for the 70D, but I did get this body only. For the most part, full frame cameras start around $2,000. So to see one for $1,300 is pretty dang good. Now, before you jump on me for being a Canon fanboy, which I kind of am, I have shot with the a7S II, with the a7R III, and several other Sony cameras. They just don't feel the same, and they're not as easy to use, and I just feel like I can jump into this camera, kill it. Very good price. I do occasionally get still photography work, so I needed something that had decent still quality, and this definitely delivers, but it is a true hybrid, so the video and the photo are both mad decent. The autofocus in this camera is second to almost none. I feel totally comfortable throwing this camera on a gimbal with no follow focus, getting in there. Another reason is that it's full frame. You get that nice buttery bokeh. You get that nice blurry background. I shot films on like the a7S II, but that was all professional work and I really didn't shoot any stills. For some reason that feels different. With the full frame, you get pretty great low light. I have shot with the Sonys. They are still better. Sonys are still better in low light, but this is good enough. I feel like with the a7S II, when you're pushing it to 16,000 and you're still like, you're cheating at that point. You're cheating. Come on, use a light. Learn how to light something. Learn how to light something up. Use a flash. Do something. I usually stick around. The highest I like to go is 6400. Otherwise, it gets a little noisy for my taste. But still, that's mad respectable. 3200, no problem. 4000, no problem. 6400, no problem. 8000, usable. Above 10,000, you're cheating. You're cheating above 10,000. Stop it. Use a light. The next thing on my list is kind of something stupid. The next thing on my list is the flippy screen. Even though when I'm using this with manual focus, I usually have a monitor on here. The next reason is the lenses. I already had a bunch of full frame lenses in anticipation that one day I would be blessed enough to own a full frame camera that could utilize the lenses. The one thing with full frame that took a lot of getting used to was the fact that you don't have as much reach as you used to. On a APS-C camera or on a Super 35 camera, you get a lot more reach out of a 24 to 70, but you can go crazy wide with this thing, which is great. So I've been using the 70 to 200 a lot more. You get to look like a professional when you're using your 70 to 200. This is like, I'm a prosumer. Look at my red ring. Then when you slap that, where is it? You slap that 70 to 200 on there. Don't talk to me, I'm a professional. Blackmagic, you can get speed boosters and all that fun stuff to make it more like full frame. Have you just been walking around my video? What are you eating? What you got to say? Okay, bye. B. being a Canon fanboy, it made sense. I got the lenses. I love the color. You can just work with this straight out of camera. You don't have to do a lot of color grading. You nail that white balance, you nail that exposure. In post, you're gonna be swimming strong. In conclusion, this is not a perfect camera. I don't think there really is a perfect camera for every situation. But for me, this made sense. I needed something that I could work quickly with in my videography stuff and that could take decent stills. And I like having a camera that I can just take around town and, you know, grab stills, grab a little video. It's fun to have something in your bag that can just pop out and do pretty much anything. It's limited to 8-bit video, which kind of sucks. It doesn't have a log profile, which kind of sucks. But it has amazing autofocus, it's full frame, it accepts all my Canon glass, the battery life is way fucking better than you Sony motherfucker. It's fine and low light, and it's around the same price as the Blackmagic. If I had to do it again, I've shot with the Blackmagic now, I've shot with the 6D, I think I would still go with the 6D. My next camera, it doesn't matter that I just got a new camera, always thinking about the next camera is gonna be...
I'm hoping there's another Ursa Mini coming out that's gonna be better in low light, actually. That would be amazing. If there was an Ursa Mini that killed it in low light, that would be the camera. But right now, I'm still conflicted. I want the Blackmagic's ability to shoot ProRes RAW, but I also want that Canon color, the available, like, I got my A cam, I got my B cam, I got my broken ass C cam, it matched beautifully, I don't have to color grade them, they just like, two keys in a pod.
But right now, I'm stuck with 8-bit 1080. Oh, 1080, I forgot even to mention 1080. This only shoots 1080 at 60. The slow motion still looks a lot better than on the Sony cameras, but you won't hear people talking about that. It's all about 4K 60, what can it do? Oh, I don't, blah, 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 blah. The slow motion on this camera, even though it only goes up to 60 frames per second, is way better than any Sony's, like, Sony just looks like choppy to me for some reason. I don't know why. The slow motion on this camera looks amazing. I probably shoot. It doesn't matter what you shoot with. It matters how much practice you put into it and whether or not it's giving you the images that you need. Professionally, the 6D Mark II made sense because it was a great option for a B camera, for corporate stuff, for commercial stuff that doesn't need a lot of color grading. It's perfect. For documentary stuff, it's perfect because you're not color grading the shit out of, I mean, some people are. Some people are color grading the shit out of their documentaries, but you can push it a little bit. The Blackmagic has a lot of drawbacks too. None of these are perfect cameras. This is just something that, like, I'm shooting a lot of documentary stuff right now. The autofocus, the auto ISO, stuff like that makes sense for this fast-paced stuff that I'm shooting right now. In the future, I would love to be able to slow it down, get more cinematic images with, you know, more narrative pieces. That's when a real cinema camera, I mean, the C100 is a cinema camera, but it's not a real cinema camera. It's more like a giant DSLR with a bunch of cool features. I don't know how to end this video. I've rambled on for way too long. If you're shooting a lot of web stuff and the 4K thing doesn't really bother you that much, this is a great camera. And the stills you get out of it are really great too. Anyhowsen, later y'all. I'll see you in the next one. This camera caught a lot of shit and I think it's a sleeper. It's a sleeper. Y'all know what that means.